Good afternoon, students. Class 10, today we are going to focus on Unit 2, Self-Management Skills. In self-management skills, we are going to see what actually is self-management, stress management, techniques to overcome stress management, importance of stress management. Okay, we'll start with the topic. What is self-management? Self-management is an individual skill to control feelings, emotions, and activities. So to first focus on self-management, what we need to do is we need to control our stress manage. So what is stress? Stress is a state of mental or emotional strain and is a part of our life. Stress can be internal. It can be from outside world, it can be an external or in a physical stress. What is importance of stress management? Why do we need to manage the stress? Stress actually is very harmful because repetitive exposure of stress may cause physical health issues, blood pressure problem, it will disturb our life. It will cause diabetes, anxiety, depression, cardiovascular diseases, and lot many problems due to stress. So, to overcome the stress, what you need to do is, you need to first categorize the stress into positive stress and negative stress. What we are going to do is, we are going to first find out which all are the stressors and what do we mean by stressors. Stressors are nothing but a wide variety of conditions, situations, and pressure which cause a stress. The stress-causing situations and pressures are known as stressors. The stressors come from external or internal factors. Now, which all are the common internal factors responsible for a stress-causing? Chronic worry, pessimism, means constantly thinking about something, getting worried for no cause, negative self-talk, unrealistic expectations from others, rigid thinking, all or nothing attitude. These all are the internal stressors. Which all are the external stressors? External means the factors which cause a stress externally, which is not in our control. Major life changes, work or school, financial problems, relationship difficulties, children and family. These all are the external stressors. Now, which all are the symptoms of stress management, stress? Cognitive symptoms, emotional symptoms, physical symptoms and behavioral symptoms. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to see different type of stress. Stress can be positive as well as negative. Now, what is positive stress? A positive stress is a stress which is caused or concludes with something which is positive. An upcoming wedding, receiving a promotion, buying home, starting new business, having kids, taking vacation, holiday season, these all are what? Positive stress. Which all are the characteristics for positive stress? It feels exciting, it improves your performance, major life changes, activities are prepared, it motivates and focuses energy to handle difficulties. Now, which all are the negative stressors? Unemployment, kids problem, legal problem, sleep problem, hospitalization, any mishap to family members, this all are negative stressors. Which all are the characteristics caused due to the stressors? Cause anxiety, concern, breathing issues, blood pressure, digestive system gets lower, the muscle becomes tense, decrease in the performance. Now, which all are the techniques to overcome to the stress? Daily exercise, meditation, yoga. Yoga is our ancient exercising technique which really manages our mental and physical health. Smile and laugh, join the laughter clubs, enjoy see all the funny videos, try to be with the happy people, get social support, be in the society, be the part of society, try to help others, be connected with the world, go on vacation, go on nature's walk, improve your time management skills, study the way you react with the stress, take care of your body, change your mindset, and spare time for family as well as for your hobbies. Which all are the benefits of this stress management? It will improve your health status, you'll have better control over emotions, you respond, you are able to assume a more positive attitude and outlook in your life, and importantly, you reduce, emulate stress in your life. So kids, we have seen the stress management techniques. Now we will turn towards the second half of the lesson, that is importance of ability to work independently. See, if you are working independently, if you are an entrepreneur, in the previous lecture we have seen what is entrepreneur. So if you are an entrepreneur, which all advantages you get for that? You become independent, you become very clear with your vision, what you have to achieve. You have no boss, so you are your own boss. You can easily focus on your work. No outside pressure on you. You are flexible at your workplace. The time you want, the way you want, the place you want, you can start with your business. You know your strengths very well. You know your weaknesses very well. You get better job satisfaction. But to be an entrepreneur, to be a self-worker, you need some skills. Which all skills you need, kids? The skills like organizational skill, to build up the organization, to form a hierarchical tree for an organization. You need to be multitasking. You should be able to do the work from ground level to the top level. You should be disciplined. Communication skills should be softened. It should keep on varying based on situations. You should be able to compromise, flexible, able to deal with rejection and not to take it very personally. Then you need to be self-aware, better deal with external factors that cannot be controlled. So try to be internally stable. A higher level of self-awareness enables us to predict how certain future situations will influence on our state of mind. So you need to be self-aware, self-motivated, self-regulated. This will help you to be a successful self-independent worker. So kids, we are done with the second unit, that is self-management, in which we have seen what is stress management, what are positive and negative stressors, what is importance of stress management, then the techniques to overcome with the stress. We have seen the importance of working independently, self-awareness. Now you are supposed to read the lesson carefully. Write down the exercise in your computer notebook. Have a good day. Bye.